Lou Granados here, Tuesday night, March 20th, doing a video demo of the issues facing the Krells. What we have is two bookshelf speakers and an NAD CD player hooked up to the Krells. They are hooked up the way they were originally at Jim's place. And you see the pre-pro here with the left and right channel hooked up and the interconnects for the CD player. And then here are the first and second inputs with the speakers hooked up accordingly. So when we play a soft Norah Jones CD, we're going to hear some distinct distortion coming from 1 and 2. So you hear the distortion issues, and what we're going to do now is shut off the equipment quickly so that we can continue with the demo. Protect it. All the equipment is off. And now what we're going to simply do is move down as Ray, the service manager at Krell, suggested we do. We're going to move the shorting pins. Incidentally, the shorting pins were missing from the amp. There were only two when I picked it up, and Ray kindly supplied me with five additional ones. So what we're going to do is we're going to move down and rushing through this a bit to make sure the video doesn't get too long for us. Simply plug everything back in. What we're going to do is keep things at the same volume level, which is a 14. Give the equipment time to cycle through. There it is. Wait for the boot sequence on the preprocessor. There we go. Set it for CD. Set it for 14, where the other level was. 14. And we're going to fire up this CD here, number 9, and hit play. And we're going to hear that there's no issue coming. Demonstration clearly illustrates the issues that the Krell is facing. Channels 1 and 2 are severely distorted, and 3 and 4 are quite better. If you listen closely, there's a tad bit of distortion as well, but not nearly as bad as 1 and 2. So there's clearly some issue with the amp, and this is Lou Granato signing off.